Now and day, musicians have access to a wide range of versatile instruments and tools. The Arturia KeyLab MK2 is able to connect, adapt, and communicate smoothly between these individual elements, making it an invaluable partner. This last episode of the tutorial series will focus on the user mode and how it allows you to customize your KeyLab MK2. We will also present how to best take advantage of your CV gate connectivity. In user mode, you can program all of the KeyLab MK2's controls, pedal inputs, and CV gate connections straight from your keyboard controller. The user mode gives you access to the global settings of your KeyLab MK2 and allows you to save several custom configurations to later recall them in a flash. You can customize your KeyLab MK2 using the Arturia MIDI Control Center, or the MCC. This can be downloaded from the Arturia Software Center or directly from the link in the description below. Simply push the user button to enter user mode. In user mode, the central knob will let you browse through the 10 user memories. Turn the knob to browse the different memory slots and click to select one. The active slot is marked with an arrow. Press and hold the user button to enter the user editor. Now, select the control you want to modify by either operating the physical control or using the arrows to browse all the controls. Some controls don't have a physical control to operate, but all can be accessed using the arrow buttons. When browsing controls with the arrows, the menu will start with the controls on the left and make its way to the right. After the controls on the right, it will continue to the rear connectivity. If you want to quickly reach a CV connection, you can select a control to jump ahead in the menu and continue with the arrows to select the CV connection. Once a control is selected, use the central knob to browse its parameters. Click to select one. Modify the setting and activate the change using the central knob. We've provided keyboard shortcuts in the user mode to maximize editing efficiency. The store shortcut will let you save custom mapping. The velo curve shortcut lets you set the keyboard velocity curve. The name shortcut modifies the name of the control that will be displayed by the screen. The mode shortcut determines the type of message that will be sent by the selected control. The option shortcut affects how the controls operate, depending on the type of control. The MIDI channel shortcut determines the MIDI channel for the selected control. The CC shortcut determines the MIDI CC or MIDI note number sent by the selected control. The Min SLB shortcut sets the minimum value of the control. The Max MSB shortcut sets the maximum value of the control. Once you've made changes, push the user button to save or discard the configuration. You will then be prompted to choose the memory slot and name your configuration. As explained in episode 1, you are able to create a split configuration and set the split point within the user mode. You can also assign the MIDI channel to each part, as well as transpose a part by octave or semitone. Chord features can also be assigned to a specific part. The basic function of the pads are open to many possibilities. Make sure the pads button is lit to be in basic function mode. By default, they are assigned to MIDI notes and offer polyphonic aftertouch. Pads can also be used as switch controls to send program changes or recall specific user memory slots. When used to send MIDI notes, or as switch controls, they can either be operated in gate or toggle mode. The MIDI channel of each pad can be set independently. All the buttons of the DAW command section can be assigned to send program change messages or to work as switch controls in user mode. They can be set in gate or toggle mode. Here in user mode, you have a total of 27 controls at your disposal. The knobs, faders, and buttons can either be used in their standard mode to send usual 7-bit MIDI CC or in RPM NRPN mode to send more specific 14-bit values for more sensitivity. When in continuous control, the knobs can be operated in absolute or relative mode. Absolute means that the value is determined by the actual position of the knob, while relative means that the values are based on the movement of the knob. You can choose between three relative modes based on the one that suits you best. We recommend that you consult their documentation to know what mode to use. The parameters and settings vary for different controls. We'll go over a few options. The acceleration sensitivity of the knobs can be modified to offer the most natural response in all situations. When in continuous control, the drawbar option of the faders can easily invert the response to match the behavior of organ drawbars. As for the buttons of the DAW command section, the select buttons can be used to send program change messages. Here is a reminder of how we return to the rear panel options. The sustain pedal is pre-mapped to send its signal through the user MIDI channel and on the appropriate MIDI CC, number 64. However, it is important to mention that it can be set as a continuous control to comply with half damper pedals. All the other pedals can be used to send between continuous and switch MIDI controls, as well as program changes. One of the groundbreaking features of the KeyLab MK2 are the CV gate connections. This serves as a great interface between your analog and digital working environments. The CV input allows you to convert an analog modulation signal into MIDI CC. For example, you can record automations in your DAW generated by modules or semi-modular synthesizers. The user editor will let you determine the MIDI channel and CC through which the converted signal will be sent. It is also possible to set its minimum and maximum value, the LSB and MSB, as well as the volt range to comply with the different norms of the modular environment. The CV gate output allows you to convert digital messages into analog signal in order to control your modular, semi-modular instruments, and any CV gate enhanced device. The pitch output sends a monophonic pitch signal. The different modes in the user editor for the pitch output are compatible with most devices. You will also be able to determine which part, one or two, will be considered as the pitch source. The pitch output sends a monophonic pitch signal. When playing more than one key, you will need to decide which note will be sent. The gate output sends a signal when a note is played on the KeyLab MK2. Source parameters that you defined for the pitch output will be the same for the gate output. We can modify the parameters to adapt to most equipment on the market that have embedded gate input. The 2CV mod out allows to send out CV signals from the knobs, faders, and buttons on the right side of the panel, as well as the mod wheel, keyboard velocity, keyboard aftertouch, and all the pedal inputs. Let's finish with a quick look at the global settings of the KeyLab MK2. Remember, they can be accessed from the user editor mode. Activate the user editor by holding the user button, then push the shortcut Global. From this step, turn the central knob to browse the different global parameters. Click the knob to select one and turn it to choose among the available settings. Then click again to save the setting. Repeat this process for another global parameter. Remember that the global settings are applied similarly to all modes, and it doesn't depend on the user memory that is loaded. The user mode features and all of its connections offer the most flexibility so that you can work comfortably in conjunction with your instruments and music devices. This concludes the tutorial series for the KeyLab MK2. I hope you enjoyed it.